I thank you, Lord, I just thank you for all those kind words, and thank you to the Church of the Center of the Book, and to Eagle Eye Books for selling my books here tonight. And above all, thank you. Thank you all so much. So there's so many of you. And what a wonderful space this is. You can never quite know what you're going to get. I know I have a funny voice, people say you need to come more now. I don't go to more now, people say you need to come more. But I do, I grew up there. And several years ago, as an effort to try to prove to the world that I really did come from there, I wrote a book about growing up in Iowa in the 50s called The Life and Times of the Thunderbolt Kid. And it was such a fantastic time to grow up in America in the 50s. It was, I think, a really magical place. I mean, I'm sure that childhood, whenever it happens to you, is always a kind of splendid event. But I think to grow up in the middle of the country, in the middle of the 20th century, in a nice, happy, middle-class household was a real privilege. They started guarding Mount Rushmore that summer. We executed the notorious anarchist Sacramento Man Zed, which was a huge, huge story, which is almost completely forgotten now. The television happened in the summer of 1927. So on, it just goes on and on. It was just kind of one thing after another. And that really became the book. That's why the book is called One Summer, because it was all of these remarkable events that happened in this one summer. But Lindbergh, I think, is really the big story of it. And I had always thought with Lindbergh that he had just somehow gotten it into his head that he was going to blind it, and he did it, and then it became famous. And then it was really as simple as that. What I didn't realize was that there was actually a really big race going on. There was something, there were lots of mixed teams that were all trying to be the first to win this very prestigious award called 14 Cards.